Hello traders, this is Elizabeth Belugina and you're watching Daily Stock Market Review by Tradimo. It's Friday, March 29th and the final trading day of the first quarter. As you can see from the daily chart, S&P 500 index gained a great deal since the start of the year. There was an uptrend after the correction to the downside seen in December. And all in all, no signs of big downward shifts here. However, currently S&P is in the phase of consolidation as the market is awaiting some news that will be able to give it direction. The most awaited news surely is the resolution of trade conflict between the United States and China. However, we do not expect important announcements anytime soon because the deal should be completed around the first half of April, so there is still some time left. This week, US representatives went to Beijing and according to Treasury Secretary Mnuchin, the talks were constructive. Next week, the talks will resume in Washington, so some minor comments are possible. In the meantime, S&P will likely remain sideways. It will be limited by uncertainty about global growth on the upside and supported by the dovish policy of the Federal Reserve on the downside. If we look at the chart of 10-year Treasury yields, we can see that the yields managed to get higher from lows. And it means that concerns about global economy somewhat declined and hopes for a deal between the US and China somewhat improved. But these are just some minor changes here, so they do not affect big trends in any way. And Treasury yields still remain low, so still markets remain quite concerned about the global economic growth slowdown. From the news which are related to particular stocks, we would like to point out Chinese Huawei company, which reported earnings today, and it turned out that its earnings rose by 25% in 2018. So the company is the world's third largest producer of smartphones. And the company is doing pretty well, all in all, despite the fact that the United States is trying to make its partners stop using telecom network equipment produced by Huawei. And it is accusing the company of having the equipment which may allow Chinese government to digitally spy over things. So the risks certainly remain, but for now we can see that the stock managed to find support at the 50-day moving average around 4.19, and this level for now keeps the stock from deeper declines, while a resistance is located around 4.60. Pay attention to the stock of Wells Fargo. Here we see a big movement today, and it is related to the news that the bank's CEO abruptly resigned, and the new leadership in the bank is necessary to fix the culture of the company, because actually the bank faces a lot of penalties from regulators which are related to abuses of consumer rights. So not really a good thing for the bank's reputation. We see this big candlestick, and more downside certainly looks possible with the nearest support located around 47 level. As for other news, ride-sharing company Lyft conducted an IPO, and it was very successful. On Thursday, the company managed to raise more money than it expected, and it is now valued at
something around $24 billion. So it was first big US tech listing this year, and more companies will follow. And as trading started, Lyft stock went up by 21% on Friday. So we can see that ride-sharing industry is really in demand and traders see great potential in it. Oil went to new highs on the news that Russia will cut production. Well, not to new highs, sorry for my mistake, but it still managed to regain some ground and all in all remains quite supported. So as for Brexit, another big topic which affects the market, there were several failed votes on different Brexit topics on Wednesday, and it turns out that probably there will be a vote on Monday. And more news are awaited related to this endless uncertainty process next week. So this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Have a great weekend. And if you like the video, subscribe to Tradimo's YouTube channel.